Space engineering. How China powering the planet from space. China energy fleet growing too fast. China has made a milestone advance in its effort to build a solar power station in space to convert the sunlight in outer space into an electrical supply to drive the satellites in orbit or transmit power back to the Earth. The Space Solar Power Station, SSPS. The futuristic project known as ZURI, or Chasing the Sun, deployed at China Zhidian University that ran a successful test of the world's first full-link and full-system solar power plant on June 5, 2022, according to a statement published by the university. The plant is a 246-foot-tall, 75-meter steel structure located on Zhidian University's southern campus, and it's equipped with 5 different subsystems meant to foster the eventual development of space-based solar power arrays. The newly built ground station is part of the team's space-based solar power proposal called OMEGA, which stands for Orb-Shaped Membrane Energy Gathering Array. Once built and parked in geostationary orbit, OMEGA will collect energy from the sun, convert it to electrical energy, and transmit it to Earth as microwaves via antenna, which then at ground station converts microwaves back to electricity. The key technologies verified include high-efficiency light concentrating and photoelectric conversion, microwave conversion, 55-meter microwave emission and waveform optimization, microwave beam-pointing measurement and control, microwave reception and rectification, and smart mechanical structure design. The idea of space-based solar power is promising, and it could help to wean us off of our global reliance on fossil fuels. Building such a complex system presents a massive challenge, but has the potential to revolutionize the way we collect energy. And while the research from Zhidian University offers an impressive proof of concept, it's only one step towards a more sustainable future. Power from space by 2028. The first launch for the construction of China's solar power project in space has been scheduled for 2028, when a trial satellite, orbiting at a distance of around 400 kilometers, will test the technology used to transmit energy from the power plant to Earth. The Chinese government aims to build a power station in 4 stages. 2 years after the initial launch, the program will send a more powerful satellite to conduct further tests. The extended power plant would be able to distribute 10 megawatts to certain military and civilian users by 2035. By 2050, the nation hopes to be able to send enough commercially affordable power from the space station to be comparable to that of a current nuclear plant. This is not the first time that this technology has been proposed, but it will be the first to be put into practice. A similar energy project has been proposed by NASA more than 2 decades ago, but was never developed. In addition, the UK has also commissioned independent research supporting a £16 billion British version of a solar power station in orbit by 2035. China's renewable energy fleet is growing too fast for its grid. China is wasting more and more clean energy as it adds wind turbines and solar panels faster than its grid is able to digest them. Nearly 12% of the power generated by wind turbines in Inner Mongolia this year has been wasted because the grid couldn't take it, along with 10% of solar power in Qinghai, Economic Information Daily reported, citing government data. In sunny and windswept but sparsely populated Gansu province, the utilization rate of wind and solar power could drop below 90% this year from nearly 97% in 2021. While China's slowing economy and energy use amid COVID-19 lockdowns has something to do with it, the main culprit is a blistering pace of renewable energy installations. China set a record for wind capacity additions in 2020 and for solar in 2021, and is set to double that mark this year. The good news is that China has developed more tools for dealing with its overabundance of wind and solar power, namely building long-distance power lines to ship it to places where it can be used and developing energy storage systems that can absorb the power and redistribute it later when it is needed. Investments in both technologies will likely increase after China's 2 main utilities recently promised to boost capital spending to help stimulate the economy.